This is 27-year-old Lyubov Yegorova of Russia. She lives with her husband in St. Petersburg. Yegorova is a national hero, perhaps the greatest female cross-country skier in Olympic history. This is 31-year-old Manuela of Italy. In three previous Olympic performances, starting at the 1984 Sarajevo Games, she has won just a single bronze medal as part of the relay team in Albertville 2 years ago. In Albertville, Yegorova competed as part of the unified team that was formerly known as the Soviet Union. She emerged from the 1992 Albertville Olympics as the greatest medal winner of the Games. Yegorova competed in five events, winning three gold and two silver medals. It is 10 a.m. Sunday, February 13th, the first day of competition after the opening ceremonies. 54 women will compete in the 15-kilometer event, a race of approximately 10 miles. The race is against the clock. The contestants will start off at 30-second intervals. The skiers who start late in the event have an advantage. Their coaches along the course and scoreboards inform them of the times they have to beat. Stefania Belmondo of Italy is the 43rd skier, going off 21 minutes after the first starter. Belmondo is the main hope for the Italian team. She won a gold, silver, and bronze medal in Albertville, and again is expected to challenge Yegorova. Thirty seconds later, Belmondo is followed by her teammate, Manuela Di Centa. For Manuela Di Centa, it will be her fourth and probably last Olympics.
My career has been frustrating. I began to have physical problems after the 1988 Calgary Games. I was always tired. I was diagnosed as having a very serious thyroid problem, which required taking medication every day for the rest of my life. Fortunately, I responded to the treatment, and before coming to Lillehammer, I had the best season of my career.
90 seconds after Di Centa, the 47th starter, Luba Vigorova of Russia.
The 15-kilometer is very special to me. In that event, I won my first gold medal in Albertville. It was not only my first, but the first gold medal won by any athlete in Albertville. And to win such a big race was so very special.
For Luba Vigorova, there is the opportunity to become an Olympic legend, to become the greatest female gold medal winner ever. At the 1960 and 64 Olympics, speed skater Lydia Skoblikova of the Soviet Union won a total of six gold medals. Yegorova has a chance to tie or surpass that mark. At the halfway point, Di Centa has set an exhausting pace. She leads Yegorova by almost 40 seconds. Nina Gavriluk of Russia is third. In fourth place, Stefania Belmondo of Italy, who started 30 seconds before Di Centa, has already been passed by her teammate. 1 by 1, the early starters come to the finish line. But in timed events, it is very rare that those first across the finish line have a chance at any of the medals. The elite skiers are always the last to go off. Finally, number 44, Manuela Di Centa, comes to the finish line. At the last checkpoint, she was more than 1 minute faster than her closest competitor, Yegorova. Yegorova approaches the finish. She is a minute and 18 seconds behind Di Centa. In third place, Nina Gavriluk of Russia. In fourth place, Stefania Belmondo of Italy. Di Centa wins her first Olympic gold medal, and Yegorova continues her amazing streak that started 2 years ago in Albertville. In six Olympic races, she has won three gold and three silver medals. Two days later, the combined pursuit, a two-race event. 5 kilometers the first day against the clock. Then 2 days later, a 10-kilometer head-to-head race. Medals are awarded for each race. Yegorova goes all out in the 5 kilometers. She knows her finishing time will have an impact on the outcome of the 10K pursuit race. Yegorova on the left comes down the stretch, passing another of the many skiers who started before her to win her first gold medal of these games and her 4th overall. In 2nd place, Manuela di Centa, 20 seconds behind. Marja-Liisa Kirvesniemi of Finland is 3rd. In 13th place, 56 seconds behind Yegorova, Stefania Belmondo of Italy. Yegorova has not only won the gold medal, but by the rules of the event, 2 days later she will start the 10K race with a 20-second head start over di Centa.
I was happy to win the silver medal in the 5K, but having to start the 10K pursuit race 20 seconds after Yegorova is almost an impossible task. 20 seconds is the equivalent of more than a 100-meter head start she will have. Besides her big lead, she's also very smart and defending her Olympic title.
2 days later in the 10K pursuit, with the race half over, Yegorova enters the stadium for the first time. She has slightly increased her lead over di Centa. She began with an almost 20-second advantage. With 5 kilometers left, she now leads by 23 seconds. The big surprise is Belmondo of Italy in 3rd place. She leads the 2nd pack, having passed 10 skiers who started before her. But she has made up less than a second on Yegorova. In the 2nd lap, di Centa makes a strong move, cutting Yegorova's lead in half. But it is not enough. As they approach the finish line, Yegorova leads di Centa by 40 meters, approximately 8 seconds. Belmondo, fastest of all in today's pursuit race, wins the bronze medal, 43 seconds behind the winner.
Number 1, Lyubov Yegorova, Russia.
Yegorova continues her streak. Now in 8 races, she has won 5 gold and 3 silver. But here in Lillehammer, Manuela di Centa is making a superb challenge. In 3 events, she has won 1 gold and 2 silver. Each will ski 2 more events, the 4x5-kilometer relay and the grueling 30-kilometer. While the Yegorova di Centa battle is going on, American alpine skiers turn in great victories. In the men's downhill, Tommy Moe came roaring down the mountain to defeat a host of pre-race favorites, including Kjetil André Aumat of Norway, Mark Girardelli of Luxembourg, and defending champion Patrick Ortlieb of Austria. His margin of victory over Aumat in 2nd place, 0.04 of a second. It was America's first men's alpine victory since the 1984 Sarajevo Games 10 years ago. 2 days later, another spectacular performance by an American woman in the Super G, Diane Roth Steinrotter, who had not won an international race in 9 years, came flying down the mountainside to win by 0.29 of a second. At age 26, Roth Steinrotter equaled Tommy Moe's feat, giving American women their first gold medal since the Sarajevo Games 10 years ago.
Hey, hey, Norge, gull, ja. Oh, yeah, hey, Norge.
It is Monday, February 21st. The women's 4x5 kilometer relay. 14 countries are entered. The favorites in the race, Russia, Norway, and Italy. There are great expectations for the Norwegian women's team. Though they have not won an individual Olympic medal since the 1984 Games, their relay teams have won a gold and two silver in three Olympics leading to Lillehammer. Yegorova on the left will ski the anchor leg for Russia. If they win, Yegorova will have her sixth gold medal, tying the Winter Olympic gold record. Any medal will give Yegorova 9 Olympic medals, one short of the all-time winter mark.
2 years ago, in Albertville, when the unified team won the gold medal, it was an honor to ski with my teammate, Raisa Smitanina. She is also my idol, and our victory took place just a few days before her 40th birthday. Our victory gave Smitanina 10 Olympic medals overall, the most ever won by an athlete in the Winter Games. If I won medals in my next 2 races, I would tie her with 10. However, the most important thing to me is the competition. I do not think of breaking records.
The race gets underway. Each skier will go 5 kilometers, a little more than 3 miles. Luba Vigorova will ski the anchor leg for the Russian team. Manuela Di Centa will ski the second leg for Italy, and Stefania Belmondo the anchor. Elena Valbe, skiing the first leg for Russia, takes the early lead. Behind her in second place, Trude Diebendahl of Norway. The prediction is that if Russia is within 10 seconds of the lead on the final pass-off, Yegorova will win the gold medal for Russia. At the first touch-off, Russia leads, followed by Norway, 8 seconds behind. Slovakia is third. In fourth place, Switzerland, followed by Finland. Manuela Di Centa of Italy awaits the touch-off. She will start in eighth place, 53 seconds behind the leading Russian team. On the second leg, Nybratten of Norway quickly passes Lazutina of Russia. Maria-Lisa Kirvisniemi of Finland, in her sixth Olympics, moves from fifth to third. Manuela Di Centa of Italy is skiing magnificently. She goes from eighth to fourth place. Nina Gavriluk of Russia awaits the touch-off for the third leg. She will start behind Ellen Nielsen of Norway. Norway starts the third leg with an 8-second lead over Russia. Finland's Merja Latinen awaits the pass-off from Kirvisniemi. Finland is in third place. Gabriella Peruzzi of Italy in fourth place gets the pass-off from Di Centa. Italy is now 27 seconds behind Finland in the battle for the bronze medal. Russia is 30 meters behind Norway as they leave the stadium. Di Centa has done her job well. She has skied the fastest leg so far and has put Italy in contention for one of the medals. Ellen Nielsen of Norway is skiing all out, trying to protect Norway's lead. But Russia's Nina Gavriluk, who won the bronze in the 15K, has cut down the distance between them. Yegorova of Russia awaits the final touch-off. Her pre-race hopes have been fulfilled. She will start her leg just a few meters behind Norway. The anchor leg for Norway, Anita Mohn, their finest sprinter. There are 75 meters left on the third leg. Now the final touch-off. Moan of Norway is off first. But Russia's Yegorova is in the position she wants to be in, just a few meters behind. As they leave the arena, Norway first, Russia second, Finland third, Italy fourth. The race goes on. Moan of Norway leads, but it appears that Yegorova can pass her at any time. In the battle for the bronze medal, Marjut Rolig of Finland is in third place, but Stefania Belmondo of Italy is moving closer with each stride. If Belmondo can catch the Finn, she will give her teammate Manuela Di Centa her fourth successive Olympic medal. Up front, Yegorova has taken the lead, passing Moan of Norway. Earlier in the week, she won the 5 kilometers in a time of 14 minutes, 8 8/10 seconds. Now here in her 5K anchor leg, she is even faster. Belmondo of Italy is also skiing well. She has passed Rolig of Finland and moves into third place. Yegorova enters the stadium. She has skied the fastest leg of any contestant in the race. An incredible 13 minutes, 21 seconds. More than a half minute faster than her gold medal victory in the individual event. Second place greets the many thousands cheering her on. Yegorova wins her 6th gold medal, tying the record for the most gold won by a Winter Olympic athlete. Anita Moan crosses the finish line. For Norwegian women, their 3rd successive Olympic relay silver. Stefania Belmondo gives Italy the bronze. The amazing streaks of both Lyubov Yegorova and Manuela Di Centa continue. In 4 events, Yegorova has won 3 gold and 1 silver. Di Centa, 1 gold, 2 silver, and 1 bronze. In 3 days, the final event in women's cross country will take place. The grueling 30 kilometers, the longest race on the women's program. It is Thursday morning, February 24th. At the Alpine Ski Center in Hafio, the women's giant slalom is being contested. 2 runs down a demanding course. The fastest first run is turned in by Deborah Compagnoni of Italy, Di Centa's countrywoman. Compagnoni leads her nearest competitor by more than half a second. Meanwhile, between the first and second runs of the giant slalom, the women's 30-kilometer cross-country race is just getting underway. The race is approximately 19 miles. Today, cross-country courses are designed to test an athlete's ability to ski uphill, downhill, and through corners. 53 women are entered. The favorites in the race, Lyubov Yegorova of Russia, and Manuela Di Centa of Italy. Again, the winners of the medals are expected to come from among the last starters. Of the favorites, Di Centa will go off first, the 45th starter. the 51st starter, Lyubov Yegorova, on the verge of making Olympic history. Out of 9 Olympic events in Albertville and Lillehammer, she has won 6 gold and 3 silver medals. If she wins, she will be the greatest gold medal winner in Winter Olympic history. If she wins any medal, she will tie her idol, Raisa Smetanina, with 10. At the halfway point, 15 kilometers, Manuela Di Centa is in the lead. There are 2 major surprises in the second and third positions. Marit Vold of Norway is in second, 30 seconds behind Di Centa. She finished 14th in the 15 kilometers. The other surprise, in third place, a mother of 2 children, 38-year-old Maria-Lisa Kervisniemi of Finland, whose Olympic career began 18 years ago at the 1976 Innsbruck Games. Earlier, she had won a bronze in the 5K. It was 10 years ago in Sarajevo when she amazed the athletic world by winning all 3 individual gold and 1 bronze in the relay. Perhaps the biggest surprise halfway through the race is that of Lyubov Yegorova. She is in 7th place, more than a minute behind Di Centa.
I was very tired for this race. That is why sport is so uncertain. 2 years ago, in Albertville, when I won the silver in this race, I finished more than 4 minutes faster than Manuela Di Centa. Now, today, she is more than 1 minute faster than me.
The race goes on. With a little more than 7 kilometers to go, Di Centa still leads. Vold is slowly cutting down the distance. She has gained 5 seconds since the last checkpoint and now trails by 25 seconds. Kervisniemi is in third, 52 seconds behind the leader. In fourth place, still more than a minute behind Di Centa, is Yegorova. Her lone hope is to pass Kervisniemi for the bronze medal. As Manuela Di Centa moves toward the finish, news has been received that Di Centa's teammate, Debra Compagnoni, has just won the women's giant slalom by more than a full second. Kervisniemi, who started a minute and a half before Di Centa, crosses the finish line. She will have to wait to find out if she won a medal. Di Centa comes down the final meters. She has the fastest time to date, defeating Kervisniemi by 32 seconds. Still with a chance for a medal, Kervisniemi congratulates Di Centa. Crosses the finish. She trails Di Centa by 16 seconds and wins the silver medal. Kervisniemi takes the bronze. Now crossing the finish in fifth place, Lyubov Yegorova. For the first time in 2 Olympic Games, she has failed to win a medal. In 10 events, she has won 6 gold and 3 silver medals.
So now the competition is over, and I was fortunate enough to win the last race. But I was equally fortunate to have as my friend forever Lyubov Yegorova. She is as gracious in defeat as she is in victory.
That night, the award ceremony takes place. First to receive the acclaim of the crowd, Debra Compagnoni, the winner of the giant slalom. A few minutes later, Manuela Di Centa. She came to Lillehammer winning only 1 bronze medal. She leaves Lillehammer with the greatest total of any athlete participating in these games. 2 gold, 2 silver, 1 bronze medal. As the many thousands pay tribute to Manuela Di Centa, there is a touch of sadness. For the first time in 5 platform celebrations, the magnificent Lyubov Yegorova will not stand beside her.